Hello friends, my name is Vasim and I welcome you all to this channel, Bang for You. So friends, in this video, we shall take up the fourth model from this topic of number system, which is based on various fundamental formulae from algebra. When it comes to bank exams, we don't have algebra as a separate topic, but then the basic formulae will be required in solving such questions in number system. So first of all, let us understand the basic fundamental formulae from algebra. So here is the formula list. The first one here is, so the first two formulae we know very well, but then it is better to remember the rest of the formulas which I have mentioned here. So the first one here is a plus b the whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. The next one is a minus b the whole square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. So the next one is a plus b the whole cube is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. See, this can also be taken as a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. So the next one, the fourth one here is a minus b the whole cube is equal to a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. Or this can again be taken as a cube minus b cube minus 3ab into a minus b. So the next one is the very important one, which I have already discussed in my speed maths video. So you can check it out in the playlist. So this video, the importance of this particular formula I have told you about. So a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So this is one of the important formulas which is useful. So remember this. A square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. Easy to remember as well. The next one is a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. The next one is a cube minus b cube is equal to a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square. The last one here is a plus b plus c the whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. So this is all about the formula list which I have which we have already discussed. So based on this formula we will be discussing some important questions. So we shall see to the questions here, right? So we shall take up the first example here. So the example here is, so the difference between two numbers is 4 and difference between the squares is 128. So what is the larger number? So as such given in the question, so the difference between two numbers is equal to 4. So and the difference between the squares. So difference between the squares. So the difference between those two numbers squares is equal to 128. So for that reason, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take up two numbers here. So one number is L, another one is S. Why I have taken L and S means, so L would be the larger number, S would be the smaller number. So for that reason, the first thing given here is the difference between two numbers is 4. So the difference between two numbers. So let us take those two numbers as L and S. So the difference is L minus S is equal to 4. So why I have taken L first and S at the last means, so it is just because, so L would be the larger number. So if you are going to subtract smaller number from the larger number, will be getting the positive value. If S minus L is taken, so the value has to be minus 4. Why? Because this would be the smaller number, right? So therefore, L minus S has to be 4. And difference between the squares is 128. So the square means, so L square. So L square minus S square. So L square minus S square is equal to 128. Right? So if you look at this, so it is in the form of A square minus B square. So we already know the formula here. A square minus B square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So therefore, so the expanded format of L square minus S square would be L plus S into L minus S, that's equal to L square minus S square. Right. So see here, L plus S, we don't know what is L plus S. Let us write it in this way, L plus S. L minus S, we already know that L minus S is equal to 4. So L minus S is equal to 4 is equal to L square minus S square. So L square minus S square we have already taken, that is 128. So 128. So that's equal to 4 1 time, 4 32 times. So therefore, L plus S is equal to 32. So we have one more equation here, that is L minus S is equal to 4. So L minus S is equal to 4. So we have two equations. So when we solve these two equations, so let us add this. So plus S and minus S gets cancelled. L plus L is equal to 2L. That's equal to 32 plus 4 is equal to 36. So 2 1 time, 2 18 times. So the larger number L is equal to 18 in this case. So what we have supposed to find out here? What is the larger number? We have already found that the larger number is 18 here. The larger number is equal to 18 here, right? So see here. So if you are enough smart, you can do this without putting all this into, without putting pen and paper by eliminating some of the options here. So see here. So the difference, we need to find out what? The larger number. So if the first option is 14, if the larger number is equal to 14, the smaller number has to be 10. Why it is 10? Because the difference between two numbers is equal to 4, right? So therefore 14 minus 4 is equal to 10. So this is done. Now the difference of the squares is 128. So 14 square we already know it is 196 minus 10 square we already know it is 100. So the difference is equal to how much? 96. So but the difference had to be how much? It is 128. So therefore, this is not the option which we are finding for. I hope you got it. The next one is, the option 2 is 16 here. So the difference of those two numbers would be 16 minus 4, that is equal to 12. So 16 square is equal to 256. So 12 square is equal to 144. If we take up the difference here, that's equal to 112. So but the difference had to be how much? It had to be 128. But the difference is not equal to 128, it is equal to 112. So this cannot be our answer. I hope you got it. The next one is 12 here. So if 12 is the larger number, the smaller number has to be 8. Why? Because so the difference of these two numbers has to be 4. So 12 square, we already know it is 144. And 8 square, we already know it is 64. So if we take up the difference here, this is equal to 80. So because the difference is 80, The difference of their squares is not equal to 128. So I can certainly say that this cannot be the answer as well. So here is the fourth option, that is 18. So if 18 is the larger number, we have to find, the smaller number would be 14. Why? Because the difference between these two numbers has to be 4. So therefore 18 square is equal to 324, and the difference of the squares, that is 18 square is equal to 324 and 14 square. So 14 square is how much? 14 square is equal to 196. So the total value would be 124 plus 4, that is 128. The difference of this square is equal to how much? 128 exactly. So therefore I can certainly say that option D has to be our answer in this case. Why? Because just by eliminating the wrong options. Let's check out the next question here. So the next question here is based on simplification. So if you look at the question here is 0.8 into 0.8 into 0.8 plus 1.2 into 1.2 into 1.2 divided by 0.8 into 0.8 minus 0.8 into 1.2 plus 1.2 into 1.2. So see here, we can see, do this question very easily. Only thing you need to know the formula which I have given you earlier. So if you know the formula, you can do it very well. Otherwise, it is very difficult for you to make it. All right. So let us further simplify this into, so see here, 0.8 into 0.8 into 0.8. So what does this mean? So 0.8 cube. This is equal to how much? 0.8 cube. Right. So 0.8 cube plus, so see here, the next one is 1.2 into 1.2 into 1.2. What else is, 1.2 into 1.2 into 1.2 would be 1.2 cube. Right. This is equal to 1.2 cube. Divided by, so see here, 0.8 into 0.8 would be 0.8 square minus, so 0.8 into 1.2, so we have to take it in that way only, 0.8 into 0.1.2 plus, so 1.2 into 1.2 would be 1.2 square, so 1.2 the whole square, right? So this is the actual equation. So if you look at the numerator, so this is like 0.8 cube plus 1.2 cube, so it is in the form of a cube plus b cube, right? So, if you look at the formula here, a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square, right? So, the equation would be, so see here, let me put it,
a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. Right. So see here, if I am going to transfer this portion to this side, to the other side, so this will be equal to, so see here, a cube plus b cube. So this will be going to the denominator as this is in the numerator, right? So therefore, this will be going to the denominator. This will become a square minus ab plus b square. So is equal to, this would be the leftward portion at the right hand side, that is equal to a plus b here. So see here, a cube plus b cube. So see here, in the numerator, it is a cube plus b cube. So a is 0.8, b is 1.2. So it is a cube and this is b cube, 1.2 is b cube, right? In the denominator, it is a square. So 0.8 square is a square minus, so 0.8 is a and 0.12 is b. So therefore, 0.8 into 0.12 would be ab plus b square would be 1.2 square. So therefore, 1.2 square here, right? So therefore, see here, the best way to do this kind of questions is that, so the outcome for this would be equal to how much? A plus b. So whatever we have got it here, so this is equal to this, right? This is equal to this and this is equal to this. And this whole portion is equal to a plus b. So simply a is how much? 0.8 plus b is how much? 1.2. So this would be the final answer. That is 0.8 plus 1.2 would be 2.0, must be our final answer. I hope you got it. So remember one thing, friends. So whenever you're solving this kind of questions in the actual examination, so if you know this method, then only you just go ahead. Otherwise, don't try to attempt these kind of questions as it is going to consume so much of your time in the actual exam. So that is why I don't suggest you to attempt these kind of questions in the actual exam if you don't know the smart way to do this. So instead of doing this, you can make so many other questions, you can do it. So that is why I just suggest you not to try all these things. Alright, so friends, this is all for today. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good day ahead. So before ending up this session, I request you to subscribe to your channel, like the video, share the video with your friends. And if you have any doubts, please let us know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Have